Understanding parenting. You might be thinking in your head, safeguarding children. What is understanding parenting? Let's just relax and enjoy this moment together. I really, really believe, this is my own belief, that you have to start with parenting. Parenting is an activity of bringing up a child as parent. Anybody can do that. You know, you can just go and get pregnant. It doesn't matter. You can be a parent if you want to be. But good parenting involves a great deal of consistency and routine. It's a great deal. It's not a joke. It's not a joke at all. It's a big deal. And it involves routine and consistency, which gives a sense of control. Good parents teach morals in what is right and wrong. So in good parenting, morals of what is right and wrong must be taught. I just want us to know this one is a foundation. All right, I really like what you said. Thank you so much for contributing. I really enjoy that. You know, this is part of understanding the unique child. Even if a child doesn't like something, there's something the child likes. However, you can train the child, at least if not liking it, to be able to at least do it. Not by force. Because you have to do it. You already used power struggle. You were in power struggle with your child. So at that time, it's really challenging. Most things, what we can do most of the time, or what we should do, you know, I tell people, everything you can turn to game. I use everything as game. Even the dishes. You can use it as a game. If you want to teach your child anything, any new skills, that's why reinforcement is also good. But just, you do one, I'll do one. Let's see. Just come up with something. You can make everything fun. Any new thing that you want to teach your child, our duty as caregiver or as parent is to look for the best way to pass across the message to the child. That is why they are unique in their own ways. Some want to just receive it. Oh, I'm happy to do that. Don't forget that person that is happy to do a particular thing, there's something that he or she will not like to do. That is the uniqueness. So our duty now is to know another way to teach the one that doesn't like a particular thing to do it. But one of the greatest methods is to just be part of it. I tell people, family bonding is very important. Family time. Team building. Team building, the word team building is not official word alone. It's not in the office. In our house, we team build every time. We have to do team building. Even that dishes sometimes, everybody will go there, even with daddy. So that is why we have to spread the good news. Parenting is for all, both mommy and daddy, caregiving. Don't forget that we are building their esteem, self-esteem. They need to believe themselves. Mommy can, you know, if mommy is not there, I can do it. So we are building them against that person that we want to abuse them or challenge them. You know, we are already building them. They'll say, no, stop. We have to teach our children to be able to say, stop, thank you. No, thank you. No, thank you. Even to you, and ask you, why, mommy? We have to be able to be open-minded to these things, and we have to accept. Encourage children to be dependent. Don't do what they can do for them. Sometimes it's not, you know, sometimes as parent, as mommy, I can really relate. If they do it for themselves, it's going to take 30 minutes. But if you do it, it's going to take 5 minutes. And because you don't have that time, let me just do it for you. We have to stop this. It's not good. Whatever they can do for themselves, please don't do it for them. Maybe for dressing up, a girl of 4 years, 5 years, if they're going to dress up, it can take forever. By the time they are putting one pant on, the wrong leg out and everything, just make sure you have that time. Create that time. Start ahead. Make sure you are not in a hurry. Let them do it for themselves until they get it right. These are things that is going to help them in safeguarding them outside world. Positive parenting. Be kind and firm when enforcing those rules. This is a very sensitive thing. You know, you want to be kind, at the same time, you have to be firm. That is you being your child's friend and sees your child seeing you as authority. These are the things that you have to put in place as caregiver, as a mother, as a father, whatever it is, so that it will protect your child from danger out there. Overpraising children does more harm than good. Over the time, I've come to realize that a lot of children that got abused, maybe sexual abuse or physical abuse, is because they are looking for validation outside. Their parents they're so used to overpraising them, and they're so used to receiving praises, good or bad. Ah, mommy, so my work, fantastic, amazing. Do you know that overpraising your child or any child that is under your care, it does more harm than good? So when we overpraise children, and when they are growing up in life and they don't get these praises anymore, they will always look around for validation. When they do something, they are not going to be satisfied. When they do something, they are not going to be pleased. Maybe in their dressing, in the way they look. And they will keep looking around. And this is when some children fall into harm, danger, sexual abuse. When you stop praising them, you know, anything can happen to parents. You cannot, you're not going to be with them forever. Imagine you've been overpraising your child from primary school, secondary school, university, or whatever it is. That child will still be looking for who is going to overpraise me if there is nobody. You know, boys will take advantage, of course. Even lecturers can take that. Oh, you're looking beautiful today. You're looking amazing. This is why some children are open to them. They are already being endangered by their parents. So we should know, as caregiver, as a guidance officer, or as a parent, that overpraising children does more harm than good.